Email signatures can be harnessed using Office 365 and your email client's built-in features manually or automatically. In this video, I described the disadvantages of this approach and explained how CodeTwo Email Signatures for Office 365 works to help automate this process and to provide a unique email signature experience in your company across all devices and email clients. In this video, I'd like to show you CodeTwo Email Signatures for Office 365 in action by associating it with an Office 365 tenant and by walking you through creating an email signature rule. To get started, I'm going to go to codetwo.com/email signatures. Click the free trial button that will take me to the page that will let me create an account in CodeTwo user panel. After creating the account, I'm taken to the application where I can associate my Office 365 tenant with CodeTwo email signatures for Office 365 and automatically create the connectors that will send my company's email through CodeTwo services located on Azure in Microsoft data centers. During the setup process, the program will ask me to provide Office 365 global admin credentials to automatically create the connectors. The program uses OAuth2 to protect my data, so it actually neither reads nor stores my credentials, but only gets encrypted access tokens from Office 365 to securely complete the setup process. Now I only have to select the scope of senders, all Active Directory users or members of a distribution group, and define if signatures should be applied to internal emails or not. Okay, now I'm ready to create my first email signature rule. The program's admin console launches and asks me to provide my global admin credentials to receive the access token again. Okay, let's get started. I'm going to type in a name and an additional description if necessary. Next, in the senders tab, I'm going to select which users will have the signature added to emails. There are several ways to do this. I can select the users one by one, add all of them at once, pick groups, or use the Azure AD filter, which is by far the coolest method. It lets me very easily configure very precise conditions. Let's say I want to create an email signature for C-level staff. I'm going to choose the Active Directory field title, leave the operator as contains, and add values such as chief, director, president, and so on. Now I'm going to switch the setting to at least one of the conditions above is met and click OK. I can also exclude users from this rule using similar criteria options in the bottom box. The options available in the email direction tab are rather self-explanatory. Basically, I can have the signature applied to all messages, only internal ones, or those sent outside of my organization. Finally, the design tab. This is where I can compose the email signature template that will be added to emails. The edit button launches the email signature template editor. If I don't want to design the template from scratch, I can use a template from the program's library as a starting point. The editor, however, is very easy to use and does not require any HTML experience, which means the signatures can be composed also by non-IT staff. The editor also lets me define whether the signature should be added directly under replies and forwards or at the bottom of the correspondence. Okay, my email signature is almost ready to go live. I'll just set the program to convert plain text emails that fall into this rule to HTML. This way, if an odd plain text email finds its way here, for example, if it's sent from iPhone, the program will still be able to add HTML fully branded signatures to it. The options tab lets me define how multiple rules should be processed. The default setting is the most common one. Now let's just click save. The new email signature rule is turned on by default, so it's already working. Thanks for watching.